So let me show you how that actually works when we use SSH. And here I'm using SSH to log into udacity.com. And what I see is a message that says the authenticity of the host can't be established. That means I don't already know a public key for the host. And we can see, because I don't already have a public key for udacity.com, that it cannot establish the authenticity of the host. It's showing me this fingerprint, which is a way for it to be more easy for a human to view the key rather than seeing all the bits in the key. If I was very paranoid and careful, what I would do is call up an administrator that I trust at Udacity and say, is this the fingerprint for our public key? If I'm less paranoid or more impatient, well, then I could connect. And once I connect, that public key is going to be stored. It's added to the list of hosts that I have. I'm not going to actually continue connecting, but now I have a secure channel encrypted with some key that's been agreed to using this SSH protocol to send my password to the Udacity host, knowing that it couldn't be intercepted. But this only has value if I really knew that this was the public key. Otherwise, I could be talking to anyone. What's happened as a result of this is now that that key has been added to my collection of keys. So now if I look in the file .ssh known hosts, I'll see that I have udacity.com here. And what's been stored is the IP address I was talking to, as well as this is the public key that's stored for udacity.com. If I try again, you'll see that it does connect. It has a secure channel now, and it's verified it by checking that the public key that the server sent matched this one. What's more fun is if I modify this file, and I'm going to make a little change to the public key. Let's change that 4 to 3. Now let's try connecting again. What happens now is we get a very large yelling message with lots of capital letters saying that the host identification has changed, that the host I'm trying to connect to sent back a public key that's different from the one that I've stored. It means that someone could be doing something very nasty. In this case, it means that I just modified the key file, and they're talking about possibly being eavesdropped on. It's really not the case that it would be eavesdropping. It must be an attack in the middle. So this is a bit of a poor wording in the error message. It's also possible that the key changed or something else happened. And so they don't allow you to continue with the connection at this point. You could modify the file to create a new key, but it's worried enough that something has gone wrong that it won't let you connect.